folks keep saying, you know, it's been nearly a year, the sky hasn't fallen, and what we've seen here in New York and what we'll see across the country is, you know, just more love, more people who, you know, truly want to be able to, you know, pledge their life and love and commitment to somebody.
When they're going through this right now, it's funny how society is all of a sudden becoming more accepting. I mean, you have it from the Oval Office right now, which is interesting, in trying to put a national push in for something like this. These are great things, so I think they're living in an exciting time, and I think it's a more accepting time for them.
However, nationally, our marriages aren't recognized. The Defense of Marriage Act still exists, and you know, we're very excited that President Obama did express his support for marriage equality and has also stated that he and his administration have no intention of defending the Defense of Marriage Act.
It's entirely possible that the President of the United States actually believes that gay and lesbian couples deserve the right to marry, and it's absolutely possible that the President, the more he learned, the more he evolved and became good on our issues and a supporter of our issues. And why should the president be any different than members of our own family? You know, be at one point and evolve to another place. I don't think we should hold the president to a higher standard.
I think it goes without saying that it was partly from his heart and it was partly political. And I certainly admire and respect the fact that he believes in it, but the reality is that he's running for re-election.
It's the first election since the passage of marriage, and we need to make sure that we stand by those who stood by us and, you know, took, you know, what for some was an incredibly courageous vote, make sure that nobody who voted for marriage loses their seat because of that vote.
I think it's ignorance and fear, and people who don't understand, who don't get it, who don't know Paul's.
At this point in our lives and in this country, you can't discriminate against anyone, and you just have to live a life that's filled with love and compassion and just love everyone.
I think marriage is still a great institution. I think it's great for to have a family and be married and have that security and of a marriage.
You know, you're conditioned to people's actions and inactions to like believe and internalize that like you're not supposed to be doing this. Even though you've moved on and you're taking these amazing steps for yourself and I think for other people too. I mean, I do feel like it's like we're part of the first sort of round of young people getting married. But the voice stays with you, I think. It may never go away.